Hello, I'm Chris Menard. I have a great Excel video for you today. This is something I actually had to do at work the other day. I need to concatenate a couple different fields, but one of the fields is a date field. And when you concatenate a date field, it does not come over as a date. This video is going to have chapters down below because I'm going to cover a lot of material, including using a helper column, concatenate, using filters. We're going to create a pivot table. So let's go ahead and dive in right now. So I have this list of employees that took orders. By the way, I intentionally left column A blank and wide because I'm recording. And if I need to show something on my screen, I don't need it popping off when I do a filter. I made myself employee 1001. That is me. I took an order on the 10/15 for $100. I really don't care about the customer number or the order number. I just threw these in here to help with this example. If you notice though, did I take other orders? Sure, here's me again, 1001 Menard on the 18th. But if you keep looking, I took another order on the 15th. So I just don't do one order per day. I take a lot of customer orders. I want to know for every employee, for every day, what was the total amount of orders that they took. So we could, just so you know this, use one of my favorite features in Excel called flash fill. And I'm going to name this helper because this is my helper column. So I could take 1001-Menard and then the next person is 1002-Wilson. If Excel doesn't pick up the trend of how you're putting in your data, you can force it with control in the letter E. It put in 1004 Santos, then 1006 Black, on and on. That's great. By the way, in case you're wondering why in the world was it control E on the data tab, if you like using the mouse, we have data tools. Here is flash fill and the keyboard tip is control E. So you could have come here and done that. My issue with flash fill in this particular example, I would not have an issue. The other day though, I had 160,000 rows of data and I get worried about flash fill breaking the logic of how data is entered and putting in something it doesn't need to. So I decided I would concatenate. So if you want to concatenate, you're going to take that number and join it with, there's your concatenate, the last name. Great. Crosshairs, autofill down, all good. I know it's correct. But I need to concatenate using a date because the employee ID is unique because we have some employees with the same last name. Notice in column C, I've got Wilson, and Wilson could be, multiple people could be named Wilson. I don't know if I did that or not. Yeah, I did. 25, 26, and 2. So the last name is not unique. It's the employee ID. But I need to join it with the date. So when you start concatenate using date, I got the employee ID. I'm going to join it with the date. Look what I get. The reason I get that, I'm going to highlight some of these dates and just copy them. I say this all the time. Dates are numbers. I'm going to paste them. There they are. And then I'm going to paste the link right here just to show you this. So if, since I did a paste link in column K, if J changes, K will change. The current date is Sunday, November 6, 2022, and that's Sunday, November 6. If I highlight these that are linked, let's use general. Dates are numbers. Microsoft Excel decided to start numbering on January 1, 1900, as you can see from this example. I'm just typing these in here right there. So that's dates or numbers. Okay. So I want to concatenate, but I want the date to show up in a certain format. We've got, I put it in there as month, day, and year, and I can show it as month, day, and year. So let's do that one right now. I need the employee ID. I would like to join with it. I don't want the employee ID and then the date right after it. I want something to separate them. I'm going to use a forward slash. You can pick whatever you want to. Just put it in between the quotes. And then I'm going to join to that. Here's the date. Watch this. Somewhat the same thing I had, except I get the forward slash now. So what I really want to do is use the text function. The text function has two arguments. What are you trying to pull? The date, which is in cell D2, is the first argument. The second argument is, how do you want to format it? I've got it in here as month, day, and year. So if I wanted to keep seeing it as month, day, and year, it's up to you. I want a two-digit month, a two-digit day, and a four-digit year. If you wanted to do a two-digit year, you could. There's the employee ID, a forward slash, and then the date is month, day, and year. But in this example, just to show you how cool the text function is, I feel like I want to go with a four-digit year followed by the two-digit month followed by the two-digit day. So I'm just changing the format of the text function on how I want this to look. That is what I want to see. Crosshairs, double click. Because I did concatenate function with the text function, I know that all of these are right compared to flash fill, which I have seen get thrown off occasionally. So I'm happy here. So now that I've got this, let's just do a quick check figure. I'm on my employee ID. I want to filter by just my employee ID. Right click, filter. Filter by selected cells value. Look, that is just me. Bottom left, you don't need to look there, but I got six records. And if you want to know, well, what is going to be my total for the 15th? I just want to check figure right here. I'm just manually using the control key now. I got four cells selected, all for the 15th down in the status bar. The sum is 722. So let's go build a pivot table, control shift L. Turns filters on and off. There you go. 722 is what we're looking for. Here we go. Insert pivot table. It picked up my entire range. Do you want to put this somewhere? I'm going to put it right here just to keep this simple. Let's go right here. Hit OK. Helper column. Invoice amount right there. 722. And if you recall here, I could double click on the 722 and I should see those four records. Let's see if that works. And we'll double click. There are the four records for the 15th. So good exercise. I know I covered a lot. I appreciate you hanging with me. Feel free to subscribe. If you have any questions at all about this, let me know. Have a great day. Thank you.